We are getting into the last stretch of Democracy 2014. Check this pile out. It's just a fraction of the political mail 7 News employees brought in today. And tonight, Marshall Zellinger is sifting through that pile, finding out which flyers might as well be junk.
I asked everyone here at 7 News to sort through their mail and bring me the political flyers they've received in the last day. And here's what I got. Now we have to filter out the junk from this mail. For instance, this one is against Bob Beaupre, and on the back here it says, as governor, Bob Beaupre could block Planned Parenthood funding. I checked with Planned Parenthood. There are certain state grants the organization stopped applying for in 2001. Planned Parenthood has not reapplied for those funds, even under 2 Democratic governors. There are funds Planned Parenthood receives from the state health department, and the governor could reduce that money, but it would require help from the state legislature. Another one here. This one says, Amendment 67 turns women and doctors into criminals, then suggests that a woman who delivers a stillborn child would be convicted of a crime. If 67 passes, it could criminalize abortions because an unborn human being would be considered a person in Colorado law. In that scenario, a doctor could be charged with murder for ending the life of an unborn child. As for the mother delivering a stillborn child, it sounds like a stretch, and it could be. But if Amendment 67 were to pass, the circumstances surrounding a stillborn death could be investigated as a crime. What else do we have here? This says, Mark Udall, he just tries to scare us with false attacks. That could be said of basically any of the ads in front of me. This one over here, red alert, warning, return your ballot before it's too late. This is scaring you into voting if you haven't yet. This one, John Hickenlooper restricted your rights. This election is your chance to restore them. This is about the gun laws passed last year, including banning magazines larger than 15 rounds, requiring background checks for all sales, and putting a fee on background checks. Even with Beaupre as governor, that would not restore the rights. He would need the state legislature to agree to repeal the laws before anything were to change. Now, we just sampled just a handful of these political mailers that you're still getting less than a week to the election. But just know that this time next week, the election will be over, and you'll have less junk in your mail. Marshall Zellinger, 7 News.